So I just wanted to come on here and explain what you're about to see, because it's gonna be pretty funny and it might not make sense if you don't know the backstory. So last week was April Fool's week, and we decided to play a prank on the Klein, Cain Orchestra students, all of them. And the prank premise was that I have a composer friend who is trying to expand his compositional range and write for high school level, because he was only writing for professional level before, and over the past year there hasn't been a lot of business for professional level ensembles for obvious reasons. So he was trying to just expand his business, and he wanted me to test a piece with my students because he knows I have lots of different levels of students and lots of people who would be happy to test a piece. So we spent the majority of the week breaking down rhythms in this piece and trying to prep everyone and really make it so that the first time that we played the piece without looking at it would be really successful, so that I could tell my friend, like, yeah, they can totally do this. And it turned out to be a piece that was very familiar, and maybe familiar from their childhood. It was really funny. All the kids were really great sports about it, and it made our whole week really fun. So I hope that you enjoy the video, and to all of the Klein Cain Orchestra students, we're sorry that we pranked you, but we're not really sorry. We loved your reaction. We love having fun with you. So I hope you enjoy this video.
Zoomies, I'm gonna publish it on the homepage. Couple more things to note. There are some little errors still that need to be fixed. Like, I'm noticing there are three measures slurred under one slur, because that can happen in wind literature, but it can't really happen in string literature. So don't worry about bowings and things like that. Just do your best. There is a key change. One, yes. Oh, flip it over.
Oh, yeah, oh, okay.
Sorry, here we go, ready? Oko, one, no, no shadow, but we're just going. One, two, three, four.
I want to play that for
it is April concert. Fool's. It's Baby Shark.
I can't believe we hyped that up for like an entire week. That's so, that is
was
great.
It actually, is there no other piece?
No, this is, it was a joke. The whole thing was a joke.
Was it let up?
Wait, so were you joking about having a friend?
No, this is wait, hold on. I do have a real friend.
I'm just kidding.
But that's not his last name. The Dubin Blazny means April Fool in Czech.
That is, wait, can we play through?
What is there to play through?
How
we just have freaking eight notes for so many
how
measures.
How long were you playing?
The whole week.
Like, when did it, the thought?
Last weekend.
That's great. That is long.
The fact that you kept messing the F sharp.
Oh, I get the rhythm now.
Okay. What the heck?
It took me a little bit.
Oh, so it just
okay. Yeah, the title's whited out. I made up all the facts, like, that there was no title and that he wanted
all that nonsense about practicing that rhythm was
just for the prank, yeah.
That is so great. I
and of course you're filming
that.
It.
Yeah, So, everybody, just remember, it's just a trial of a piece. We're just trying to get, like, not only are you gonna, you know, demonstrate your sight reading, but also we're just getting a trial of what this piece sounds like. So there may be some bowings that don't make sense because this composer's not a string player, or maybe some other stuff that doesn't make sense. What?
He's trying his best.
Oh yeah, he is trying his best.
Maybe.
Can we do it without me first?
What a true.
as soon as the April Fool's thing.
Oh my gosh, I was like.
I know, it's sad. Tell us our plan. I was like, oh no. You gotta start reading the notes.
I know, I was.
This was the best I've ever done.
Hey Kevin, can you check if my phone is recording? I don't remember if I pressed record or not.
Yeah, it's recorded.
Okay. Although guys, a couple more notes before we turn it over. Like I said, he's like a French horn player, so some things are still a little strange. Like in the beginning violins, I see there's like almost four measures that are slurred in one slur. Don't worry about that, okay? Just do your best. I've made some markings for him. In wind literature, it's a little different, so.
Three, four. More confidence. Louder. He wants us to test it out. So I'm actually having every class test it so that he gets like an idea of this is like what a varsity group might sound like on this. And this is what, you know, maybe you need to adjust some things for a group that's a little bit, you know, entry level. So, but when I saw the score, I was like, yeah, they can try to do that. And he was like, no, I don't think so. And I was like, no, I'm pretty sure. And so, that's why I haven't shown it to you yet, because what I want to do is like pass it out face down and have you flip it over, not even shadow ball, like we're just going to play it. Just to I'm that confident, okay? I told you it was loosely based on the workshop 9, the finale, do you guys know that?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, and so a little bit contemporary because I have that rhythm. Okay, flip it over. Ready to play? Here we go. One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
Stefania is a real person.
You sure?
But that's not his last name.
I was wondering.